Hello and welcome, and this is News Mobile. Today morning, Home Minister Amit Shah has tabled the Citizenship Amendment Bill in the Rajya Sabha. Now, of course, that comes in after it was passed in the Lok Sabha. This happened after a long discussion that happened there, heated discussions that spanned almost over 7 hours. The bill was passed in the Lok Sabha with a majority of 311 votes against the 80 votes. Now, this is where 391 members were present. Now, this is what happened in the Lok Sabha, and today at 12 o'clock is when Home Minister Amit Shah has finally tabled it in the Rajya Sabha. The discussions are going on, the debate is still going on in Lok Sabha, and you can tune in to newsmobile.in to go through and to see the entire live debate that's happening. But really, what is it that Amit Shah spoke about when he tabled it in the upper house? Now, very clearly, it is a very important move for the BJP-led NDA. It is going to be very crucial, because it's only after the bill gets passed in the Rajya Sabha that it can finally be enacted as an act. Now, what is it that he said? Now, Amit Shah very clearly has mentioned, and when he was giving facts, he very clearly said that there has been an almost 20% decline each in population of religious minorities in both Pakistan and Bangladesh. He said that either they were killed or they fled to India for shelter. So really setting the context for the reason why minorities, religious minorities other than non-Muslims who come into India should be given citizenship, and that becomes the major part of the entire debate as to why the Citizenship Amendment Bill at all. So that is how he started the entire debate. He kind of continued and said that religious minorities from Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan who have come to India will be given Indian citizenship. So really the entire bill is for these three countries, for the non Muslims who are from these countries and who are now in India. The cutoff date is 31st December 2014, and earlier to get citizenship it was a residency period, it was for 11 years. The bill proposes it to be cut down from 11 years to 6 years. So that is what it is. However, he also stated that there is not going to be any discrimination that's going to happen for Muslims who are already in India, the Indian Muslims, and he said that is one of the main concerns that is coming out. There are rumors that are getting spread. He very clearly hinted on false information and fake news that is doing the rounds, and he said that Muslims who are citizens of India will remain so, they will not be discriminated again. He said that we cannot give citizenship to Muslims from other countries, but nothing happens to the ones who are already in the country, who are a part of India. They remain an important and integral part of India. He also said that they do not need to worry. Misinformation has been spread about the bill against the Muslims in India, and he said that they should not be misled by that. So that was Home Minister Amit Shah speaking in the Rajya Sabha as he tabled the very controversial yet crucial Citizenship Amendment Bill. Now, he also spoke about the states, and he also said that this bill will not be applicable to scheduled tribes. Citizenship will also not apply to Mizoram. So he has set up very clearly as to what where it's going to be set and what's going to happen. He also said that he's going to devote enough time to question and answers. He assured all the members of the Rajya Sabha that all their queries and doubts will be answered by him. He said that he's absolutely ready for it. He said that the party has done their homework, have really thought about the entire thing before bringing it to the parliament. Now, this of course is, as I mentioned earlier, extremely crucial from the fact that there has been a lot of debate around it. A lot of parties, for example, Congress and others, have come forward and opposed the Citizenship Amendment Bill, and they have very clearly said that this may not be the right thing for India at this particular time. Now, the time allocated for discussion in the Rajya Sabha is 6 hours, which is what is going to happen right now, but which is going on right now. But meantime, there have been violent protests that have been going on since day before, since the time the bill was passed in the Lok Sabha. Even as I talk to you right now, mobile data and SMS services have been suspended in the entire state of Tripura, Assam, Guwahati, Dibrugarh. Immense and very massive protests are going on there. The locals there are extremely against the implementation of the bill, and they are saying that it is not something which is in the right spirit and ethos of the country. Bihar, there is a protest that is being led by Tejasvi Yadav in Patna. Tamil Nadu, the protests are going on, and Aligarh Muslim University is on a high alert. So really, protests are going on. The government is trying to ensure that they have the right measures in place to ensure that they do not take up a very critical turn and the events can be controlled. But right now in Rajya Sabha, the debate is on. There are the debate is on, as I said. The other parties are also going to be talking about it, and after that, after the entire discussion, there is going to be question answer, which is what Home Minister Amit Shah has said, that he is absolutely ready with data, ready to answer all the questions that are being put up to him. So that is the main news of the day. We are going to bring you live visuals. The entire debate is going to be live on News Mobile. So do log in and stay tuned, and as and when there is any other news, any other big development in this, we are going to come back to you on this. Thank you.